So later, I am writing what the things we completed in the previous class. So I think introduction chapter is going on. That's not completed as we know. And I think first we studied some basic Linux commands. After that, we implemented Hello World, this Hello World program in C, C++, Java, and in Python. And also we know how to compile the program and how to run in C, C++, Java, and in Python. So this much concept we studied in the previous class. And introduction chapter is not completed. I told you in the previous class that if you were telling someone that, sir, I know Python, you know what the front person will think? The front person will think that you are master in C, C++, Java. That's why you were telling, sir, I know Python. So in introduction chapter, we will spend some time on C, C++, Java. After that, we have to go for Python programming language, right? So we know in the previous class, we studied in the previous class that any program we can implement in C, that program we can implement in C++. Also, that same program we can implement in Java. That same program also we can implement in Python. In the previous class, we implemented Hello World program in 4 programming languages. That means any objective that given to you, that may be factorial calculation, strong number, Armstrong number, that may be creating a website, any programs you are getting, any objective is given to you, that objective we can implement it through C, also we can implement it through C++, we can implement it through Java, also we can implement it through Python. By using any programming language, we can achieve our objective. That's proved in the previous class. We already got some demo with the Hello World program, right? So I am making some architecture. After that, you will get some clear visualizations how to work with them. So let me allow to access my digital whiteboard. So just clearly, I want to implement some architecture you can identify. So we can implement some program through C. Same program we can implement it through C++. Same program also we can implement it Java. Same program also we can implement it by using any programming language. We can implement any object. Achha, okay, finally, let there is a user, and user basically does not require any program. For user, what is required? You can identify for user program is not required. For user, basically what is required? Output is required. And to get the output, first we have to implement the program. That program can be implemented through C, also can be implemented through C++, can be implemented through Java, also can be implemented through Python. So what the program you are implementing, that program is technically called, just remember this technical word, that program is technically called source. That may be a C program, that may be a C++ program, that may be a Java program, or that may be a Python program. That may be any kinds of program. Whatever the program you are writing to get the output, that program is technically called source code. Main thing is what here? User does not require your program. User requires only the output. And to get the output, we have to implement some program. Main thing is what here? Output, what user wants. That output is not generated by C. Output is not generated by C++. Output is not generated by Java. Output is not generated by Python. Yes, this is right. C cannot provide the output. C++ cannot provide the output. Java cannot provide the output. Python cannot provide the output. Then who provides output to the user? That may be C, that may be C++, that may be Java, that may be Python. Just remember this point. Programming language never provides output to the user. So now questions here. If programming language does not provide output to the user, then who provides outputs here? That's very easy. That may be any programming language. Finally, all the programming language will work through your microprocessor. In your system, there is a device available in your system that's called microprocessor, or we can tell that is our machine. Remember this point. Programming language never provides the output to the user. Who provides output to the user? We can tell microprocessor, or we can tell that's our machine. C works through microprocessor to provide the output. C++ works through microprocessor to provide the output. Java works through microprocessor to provide the output. Yes, Python also works through microprocessor to provide the output. So this is clear, I think. Programming language is used to implement the program, but programming language cannot generate the output. Who generates the output in a programming language? Yes, we know that's our microprocessor, or we can tell that's our machine. Another important thing is what here? What the machine we know, microprocessor is not educated person. Means we are educated. We know what is C programming language. We know what is C++ programming language. We know how to write a Java program. We know how to write a Python program. But microprocessor cannot understand what is C. Microprocessor cannot understand what is C++. Microprocessor don't know Java language. Microprocessor don't know Python language. Means microprocessor cannot understand the source code. Microprocessor cannot understand source code. So for this microprocessor, basically source code is not required. For the microprocessor to generate the output instead of source code, which code is required? I think you know. For the microprocessor, we have to generate machine code. Right? Just remember this technical word. One is source code, another is our machine code. What the program we are writing, that program is nothing but that's the source code. But to get the output, finally, microprocessor will work. But microprocessor cannot understand our program, cannot understand the source code. So we have to convert our source code to machine code. After that, microprocessor will work with that machine code, and it will generate the output and provides output to the user. In this way, your architecture will work. So at least from this architecture, we identified what is the importance of machine code. Okay, later I am deleting this architecture. So at least from this discussion, we studied two different technical words. One is source code, another is what? Machine code. Yes. Another important thing is what here? You know, every code has some extension. Every code has some extension. Like C code, what are the extension for C? Yes, we know .c extension. For C++, what the extension is required? .cpp. For Java, what the extension is required? .java. And for the Python, the extension is required .py. Like that. For the machine code, you know that machine code also requires some extension. Which kind of extension? It depends on your operating system. If you are working on Linux operating system, the machine code extension will come in the form of .out. If you are working on Windows operating system, at that time .out is not the extension of your machine code. At that time, the machine code extension is required .exe. I think you know this concept. If you are working on Android operating system, Android is also operating system. At that time, your machine code extension is required .apk. So if you will change your operating system, according to your operating system, your machine code extension will be changed. If you are working on Linux, the machine code extension is required .out. If you are working on Windows, the machine code extension is required .exe. If you are working on Android, the machine code extension is required .apk. So just forget about this Windows, forget about this Android, because we are using Linux operating system. So for this Linux operating system, what the machine code extension is required is, you know, .out extension is nothing but that's our machine code. So from this discussion, we identified what is source code, what is machine code, how machine is working with machine code and provides the outputs to the user, and what is the extension, of machine codes. So according to this discussion, I am writing some program by using any programming language. We have four programming languages, right? C, C++, Java, and Python. And what are the things we studied here? I will prove these things in four programming languages. So first, I am going for C. I have a file having the name main, and I want to write a C program. We know from the previous class, .c extension is required. And also, you know how to implement a program in C, stdio.h. Next, I have to implement main function. Inside the main function, if you want to print something, then we have to use printf. Provide the message, any message, hello world, and take a slash. And you know what is the requirement of slash. So you know that what the program now we implemented with the help of C programming language. This program is not the machine code. This program, we can tell, this is our source code, C source code. So if I'll move back in our list, yes, my source code is available having the extension .c. But from this source code, we cannot get the output. If I will send this source code to machine, just carefully observe. If I will give the instruction execute main.c, machine is giving the message. What the machine is telling to me, it's giving permission denied. Means machine cannot understand C programming language. So for machine, which code is required exactly? Source code is not required. Machine code is required. And this is Linux platform. For that, the machine code extension is required.out. So to get the output, we have to convert our source code to machine code. To convert the source code to machine code, we cannot convert directly. We have to take the help of compiler. And you know for C, which one is the compiler? In the previous class, I told you, GCC is the compiler for C that belongs to Linux operating system. GCC, please take my source code and give me the machine code. Now, if I will get the list, you can identify. Before compilation, there was only one file, source code. After compilation, I have two different files. One is source code, another is machine code. And what the extension you are looking? Yes, that's .out extension. Why? Because we are working on Linux operating system. If I will go for main.c file, yes, we can understand this program. But like that, if I will on dot out file, we cannot understand. We cannot understand what the codes are written here. Why? Because this is machine code. This is not for user. This code is designed for the machine. So who can understand? Machine can understand. So what the code we are not able to understand, that code machine will understand. So for that, we have to send that code to machine. Jo code hum samajh nahi pa rahe the, wo machine samajh sakta hai. To uske liye mujhe wo code ko machine tak pahunchana hoga. Machine tak pahunchane ke liye command kya hota hai? /error. Now if I will press enter, that code will register inside the machine. Machine will work with that and it's providing the output. Yes, hello world. It's working. So what the things we implemented here, according to that, if I will make some architecture, then I think you can get some better visualizations there. So just carefully identify how the architecture will looks like. Later, I implemented a program. Later, I implemented a program in C. Later, I have a program in C, .c extension. And finally, there is a user. There is a user, and you know, finally, for the user, what is required? Output is required. And also, you know, who provides the output in any programming language? That's our machine, or we can tell that's our microprocessor. This is our microprocessor. What the program we implemented in the form of .c? That program is technically called which code? That program is technically called, we know, that's our source code. Right. If I will send this source code to machine, then what will happen? We know machine cannot understand source code and it will give some message, permission denied. Why that message you are getting? Because machine have no any authentications to understand the source code. So for that, what is required? Before sending the source code to machine, we have to create some file. So we have to convert. We have to convert our source code to which code? You know, we have to convert our source code to machine code. We are working on a Linux platform. For that, what the extension is required? Dot out extension is required. We have to convert our source code to machine code. We cannot convert directly. For that, we have to take the help of the compiler. And which compiler for C? You know, GCC compiler. If I will send the source code to the GCC compiler, it will work on that and it generates the machine code. Once the machine code is generated, after that, if I will send this machine code to the machine, now machine can understand, and according to that, it provides the output to the user. I think this architecture is clear for you. First, we are implementing a file having the extension .c. That's a C programming file, source code. So GCC is nothing but that's our compiler. Which compiler? That's our C compiler. And you know, for GCC, like GCC, in C++, the compiler name is G++. In Java, the compiler name is Java C, right? In every programming language, there is a compiler you will get. So in this way, your C is working. Okay, if I ask now, after getting this architecture, please concentrate. After getting this architecture, now if I'll ask you, what is the responsibility of compiler? If I'll ask you, what is the responsibility of compiler? Compiler ka kaam kya hai? If any person is asking, why compiler is required? Or what is the work of the compiler? Or what is the responsibility of compiler? Definitely some question comes to your brain. Sir, you made the architecture according to the architecture you are telling, and according to architecture, when you were telling, after that you were telling that all the definition is wrong. Main thing is what here, this architecture is valid architecture. What the architecture is available in front of you, that architecture is valid, no any problem. But this is the basic architecture. Many things are there what we don't know. So let me allow to complete this architecture from basic level to advanced level. So let's check. You can easily identify according to this architecture. To convert the source code, to convert the source code to machine code, there is only one step is available. Which step is available? GCC is the step, and GCC is nothing but that's our compiler. That's why you were telling, sir, compiler is responsible to convert our source code to machine code. But what C is exactly telling? C क्या बोल रहा है? हमको ये लग रहा है कि source code को machine code में convert करने के लिए एक step काम कर रहा है. And what is that step? Compiler. Compiler is the step here. But C is telling that to convert the source code to machine code, source code को machine code में convert करने के लिए one step is not working. एक स्टेप काम नहीं करता है. देन हाउ मेनी स्टेप्स आर वर्किंग देयर? वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई, यस, फोर डिफरेंट स्टेप्स आर वर्किंग. फर्स्ट स्टेप, सेकंड स्टेप, थर्ड स्टेप एंड फोर्थ स्टेप. वी आर थिंकिंग वन स्टेप इज ओनली वर्किंग, बट वन स्टेप इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली वर्किंग. इंटरनली फोर स्टेप्स आर वर्किंग टू कन्वर्ट द सोर्स कोड टू मशीन. व्हाट द फर्स्ट स्टेप? प्लीज कंसेंट्रेट. We will prove also. The first step is nothing but that's called preprocessor. Second step is the compiler. Third step is the assembler. Fourth step is the linker and loader. To convert the source code to machine code in C, internally four steps are working: preprocessor, compiler, assembler and linker loader. Right? Acha, again, please concentrate. What is the compiler name in C? We know, sir, compiler name in C, that's easy for us, that's GCC. Right? Very good. जिस तरीके से कंपाइलर का एक नाम है, उसी हिसाब से प्री प्रोसेसर हैव ए नेम. व्हाट इज द प्री प्रोसेसर नेम? जस्ट रिमेंबर, सीपीपी. हियर सीपीपी डज नॉट स्टैंड फॉर सी प्लस प्लस. हियर सीपीपी स्टैंड फॉर सी प्री प्रोसेसर. थर्ड स्टेप इज द असेंबलर. व्हाट इज द असेंबलर नेम? असेंबलर नेम इज एएस, स्टैंड फॉर द असेंबलर. What is the linker loader name? Linker loader name is what? LD, right? So according to this discussion, we know that previously we thought to convert the source code to machine code, one step is there, only the compiler. But from this architecture, now we can identify to convert the source code to machine code, one step is not available, four steps are available there: preprocessor, compiler, assembler, and what? Linker and loader. We know the preprocessor name is CPP, compiler name is GCC, assembler name is AS, linker loader name is LD. Yes, LD, command available. But instead of LD, just remember what I am doing. Instead of LD, agar koi puch raha hai linker loader ka naam kya hai, then you have to tell, yes, linker loader name is LD. LD command is also available. इस तरीके से इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी नो एलएस इज अ कमांड, पीडब्ल्यूडी इज अ कमांड, एमपीडीआईआर इज अ कमांड, लाइक दैट सीपीपी इज अ कमांड, जीसीसी इज अ कमांड, एएस इज अ कमांड, एलडी इज अ कमांड. एलडी कमांड इज अवेलेबल, बट इंस्टेड ऑफ एलडी कमांड वी विल यूज जीसीसी कमांड. जस्ट रिमेंबर, because ld command ka istemal karne ke liye you have to keep some idea regarding libraries. Libraries ke bare mein study karna hota hai. We have no idea regarding libraries, what is static library, what is dynamic library. So to avoid that library mechanism, instead of ld, what the command I will use? GCC command. But still, if any person will ask you what is the linker loader name, don't tell GCC. Linker loader name is what? LDK. Okay. So according to this discussion, what we implemented, later, give me some time to prove this discussion is valid discussion or that's the invalid discussion. So let me allow to delete all the things. After that, I will give some proof in front of you, then you can get the clear visualization. In computer science, there is no any theory. Everything is practical. So what the discussion we implemented, I think you were just writing something. Whatever the thing you are feeling that's important, just write yourself. So later, I am going to my system and let's prove what are the things we discussed. Okay. I am deleting the previous machine code what was generated. You can identify only one file is available, that's our source code. When I am giving this command, in this command, one step is not working. With this command, internally, four steps are working. And after that, our machine code is generated. And if I will execute that one, we are getting our output. But what I want to do now, I don't want to move that four step with single command. मैं जो चार स्टेप हम जानते हैं वो चार स्टेप को एक कमांड से मूवमेंट नहीं करना चाहता हूं. आई वॉन्ट टू मूव स्टेप बाय स्टेप, फर्स्ट स्टेप, देन सेकेंड स्टेप, देन थर्ड स्टेप, देन फोर्थ स्टेप. वी नो द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज नथिंग बट दैट्स आवर, यस यू आर राइट, प्री प्रोसेसर. वी नो द प्री प्रोसेसर नेम इज वॉट, सीपीपी. गिविंग द इंस्ट्रक्शन जेनरेट द आउटपुट फाइल हैविंग द नेम main.i from main.c. So here hyphen o, what the hyphen o I given here, this stands for output. What the output is required? main.i. what is the input file? main.c. if I will press enter, in this list you can identify one file is created. Which file is created? .i file is created. Again, I'm just repeating. For the first time, .c file was there. .c is converted to .i with the help of a preprocessor. If I'll go for our second step is nothing but that's our compiler. You know, compiler name is GCC. Giving the instruction, generate assembly file. This S instruction generate the assembly file. Just remember what the technical words I am using. And this S is the capital S. Just identify. This O is the small o, but this S is capital S. Generate assembly file from the lastly created file. What the last file was created? I think main.i. Right? If I will get the list, you can identify. .c is converted to .i. Dot I is converted to dot S, right? Again, dot C is converted to dot I with the help of a preprocessor. Dot I is converted to dot S with the help of a compiler, right? Now this is the time to move for the third step. What the third step was there? We know the third step is the assembler. You know the assembler name. Assembler name is AS. Assembler generate the output file main.o from the last created file. What the last created file? main.s. If I will get the list, you can identify the new file is generated having the extension .o. So if I will tell how these files are created, .ce is converted to .ie, .ie is converted to .s, .s is converted to .o. So this is sorted according to dictionary. According to dictionary, this is sorted. That's why .o come first, after that .s is coming. This is not sorted according to time. So don't think that from .i, .o is created. We know .c converted to .i, .i converted to .s, and .s is converted to .o. So from the fourth step, I think the first step, preprocessor that completed, compiler completed, assembler completed. I think the last step is the LD. I want to generate. Okay, finally, which file is required? After all the step, we require the machine code having the extension .out. I am telling generate a.out, and what the last created file? main.o. But instead of linker loader, I told you LD command is available. Definitely LD command we can use. But instead of LD command, which command we have to use here? GCC. That's not mean that LD we cannot use. Yes, we can use LD. But we use LD command, we have to get some knowledge on static library, dynamic library. After that, we can use. So I just want to avoid the complicated things. That's why instead of LD, I use GCC only. And finally, if I will check, yes, my .out file is generated here where my cursor is blinking. And if I will run that output file, you can identify I am getting my message hello world. So this is proved here. To convert our source code, to convert our source code to machine code, source code ko machine code mein convert karne ke liye, how many steps are working on C? Four steps: preprocessor, compiler, assembler, and linker loader. But here, instead of linker loader, we are using the GCC command because we have no any library concepts. According to this discussion, if I will make the architecture, then how this architecture will looks like? Please concentrate. According to this discussion, if I will make the architecture, then how this architecture looks like here? For the first time, .c file I have, it's going inside the first step. The first step is nothing but that's our preprocessor. And from the preprocessor, which file was created? .i is created. .i is moving inside for the second step. That second step is our compiler. And from this compiler, .s file was created. .s will move inside the third step, that's our assembler. From this assembler, .o file will be created. .o file will move inside the linker loader. And from this linker loader, which file will be created? We know .out file will be created. This .out file will move inside the microprocessor. This .out file will move inside the microprocessor. Microprocessor will provide the output to the user. In this way, your C is completely working. This CPP is nothing but that's our preprocessor, compiler, assembler, and a linker loader. We know that .c file is technically called which code? That's technically called source code. Like that, dot out file, we know, just concentrate, dot out file is technically called which code? We know that's called, yes, machine code. Like that, dot i file is technically called intermediate code. Dot s is technically called assembly code. And .o is technically called object object. Right? After getting this architecture, again, if I'll ask you, what was the responsibility of compiler, or what is the responsibility of compiler? When I asked the same question previously, you given the answer, sir, compiler is responsible to convert the source code to machine code. Compiler is responsible to convert the source code to machine code. But after getting the real architecture, after getting the complete architecture, after getting the complete architecture, and please confirm here, is compiler is responsible to convert the source code to machine code? That's completely wrong. Compiler is not responsible to convert the source code to machine code, sir. Then what is the responsibility of compiler? Compiler is exactly converting intermediate code to assembly code. Is that clear? Yes. Compiler is responsible to convert intermediate code to assembly code, not to convert source code to machine code. I proved that concept in C. Like that, we have to study in C++, Java, and Python. Huh? Important thing is what? If you are spending some time in one language, that's important. If you are spending some time in one language, that's not the wastage of time. It will definitely help in other languages. Like, if you know array in C, array mechanism in C, same array in C++, same array story in Java, same array story in Python. So main thing is what here? If you are spending some time in one language, that's not the wastage of time. Definitely, it will give some merits in other language also. So I think this architecture is clear for you. And why I am telling, compiler is not responsible to convert the source code to machine code. Yes, compiler is never responsible to convert the source code to machine code. I proved in C. C mein prove kiya hai. Isi hisab se C++ mein bhi prove karenge. Java mein bhi prove karenge. Then we will go for the Python architecture. This is the architecture of C. Jis tarike se C ka architecture study kiya hai, usi hisab se C++ ka architecture ko study karenge. Java ka architecture study karenge. And after that, we will move for the Python architecture. Then we will get the better visualization. After C architecture, we have to go for C++ architecture. After C architecture, we have to go for C++ architecture, right? Main thing is what? Just look in this architecture. C architecture is exactly same as C++ architecture. C++ architecture is exactly same as C architecture. C mein char step hote hain, C++ mein bhi char step hote hain. The difference is what? In C++, you know, compiler name is not GCC. In C++, yes, very good. The compiler name is what? G++. Another thing, in C, the source code extension is required .c. But in C++, yes, right. What the extension is required? .cpp. Only these two things will be changed. And all the other architecture will be exactly same. Yes, in C++, preprocessor is there, .i file is there, compiler is there, .s file is there, assembler is there, .o file is also there, linker loader is there, and .out file is also there. So before deleting this architecture, let I am proving through my system. Let carefully just observe here. This list is completely empty, nothing here. I want to generate a C++ program. File name to kuch bhi ho sakta hai, but extension .cpp chahiye. And you know how to implement a C++ program. This first program you have to remember compulsory. Has include iostream using namespace std. I have a main function. Inside the main function, if you want to print something, then you know cout is required, giving some message. and take a slow set. If I will get the list, only one file is visible here, .cpp file. That's nothing but that's our source code. C++ source code. The first step was preprocessor. Second step, compiler. First step, assembler. Fourth step, linker loader. I'm just going for the commands now. Just careful observe. Preprocessor generate the output file having dot I extension from dot cpp. If I will get the list, dot I is generated from dot cpp. Dot I is nothing but that's our intermediate code. Second step, compiler generate assembly file from dot I file. If I will get source code converted to intermediate code, intermediate code is converted to assembly code. Assembler generate the output file having the extension .o from .s. If I will get the list, source code converted to intermediate code, that converted to assembly code, that converted to object code. Linker loader is the final step, you know, that's required to be changed because you don't know how to use LD command. Generate dot out file, generate the machine code from the object. And you know, LD command is available due to we don't know library mechanism. I am not using that command. Instead of that, I am using G++. You know, for C++, G++ we have to use. Now if I will get, yes, my machine code is generated. And if I will run that one, I am getting hello world. I am C++. So you can identify, I told you previously, if you are spending some time in one language, that's not the wastage of time. It will definitely help in other language. You can identify. C architecture study karne ke liye, how many times it taken. But to complete the C++ architecture, how many times it's taken. Right? So that's proved here. If I'll go for the again architecture page, you can identify. Yes, in C++ also, source code is there, intermediate code is there, assembly code is there, object code is there, and machine code is there. And also in C++, compiler is not responsible to convert the source code to machine code. C++ maybe, agar aap architecture dekh pa rahe hain, to compiler source code ko machine code mein convert nahi karta. In C++ also, compiler converts intermediate code to assembly code. Okay. So before discussing on Java steps, first let me allow to write the Java program what we know from the previous class. I am deleting all the C++ concepts. How you can identify, I am using rn star. Star means all. All files will be deleted. So if I will get the list, all the files deleted. So you can use this command. In the previous class, I not told this command, rm star. Star means all file. Right. So now we have to spend some time on Java architecture. That's completely easy. Before understanding the architecture of Java, let me allow to write the Java program. Demo.java, we know to write a Java program, .java extension is required. Let I have a class, demo. Why a class? That's not the right time to explain. You have to remember the first step of learning. We have to remember many things. Then public static void main, and for the command line argument, we have to use string args, that's an array. And if you want to print something, system.out.println, that's something complicated. I think that not something complicated, that's more complicated. Personally, I am telling. And give some message, hello world. I'm not giving a long message. That is a short message. And you know, here slashing is not required. It will take by default slashing. It will take by default slashing. We know. Achha, once the program is completed, now we have to go for the architecture. We have to go for architecture, right? If you have the idea on Java, know any idea on Java, that's okay. But what we are discussing, we have to remember. Let I am going for the architecture phase now. We know in C, four steps are there. In C++, four steps are there. Like that, what is the Java architecture? How Java architecture will look like? In Java, is there an intermediate code? Is there an assembly code? Is there any object code? So what the Java architecture is telling here? In Java programming language, internally, there are not four steps like C++. In Java architecture, internally, there are two steps. Only two steps are there. The first step is the compiler. Second step is not linker loader. Second step is what? Interpreter. Just remember, in Java, two steps are working. The first step is the compiler. Second step is the interpreter. In C, the compiler name is GCC. In C++, the compiler name is G++. Like that, in Java, the compiler name is what? We know in the previous class. Java. जिस तरीके से कंपाइलर का एक नाम है उसी हिसाब से इंटरप्रेटर का एक नाम होगा. व्हाट इज द इंटरप्रेटर नेम इन जावा? द इंटरप्रेटर नेम इन जावा इज इटसेल्फ जावा. इज इटसेल्फ जावा बट टेक्निकली कॉल्ड जेवीएम. आई थिंक दैट यू मे नो जावा, यू मे नॉट नो जावा, बट आई थिंक यू नो द जेवीएम फुल फॉर्म. जेवीएम स्टैंड्स फॉर Java Virtual Machine. JVM stands for Java Virtual. V stands for Virtual. M stands for Machine. In Java, two steps are there. Compiler and interpreter. The compiler name is Java C. Interpreter name is Java, technically called JVM. So this is a technical name. JVM is not a command. The command we have to use Java. Java command, Java is a command, JVM is a name, just remember, JVM is a technical name, but what the command we have to use? Java command we have. JVM stands for Java Virtual Machine. So only two steps are there. So I am going to my system and let's proving, yes, two step, how to work with that two step. So you know, I have the source code in java.java, that's our source code. The first step is the compiler. We know the compiler name is Java C. Take my source code. And after the compilation, if I will get the list, you can identify, yes, Java file is available, sir. There is no any problem. But another file is created. Can you identify? Yes. Another file is created after the compilation having the extension. What the extension is given? Yes, dot class extension. And that dot class file is generated after what? After the compilation, right? What is the second step? Second step is the interpreter. JVM, if I will provide, it's giving the message JVM command not found. So what is the command for the interpreter? Java command. What the last created file? Demo.class is the last created file. But you know, dot class is not required to mention. Dot class is not required to mention, only provide the file name. Now if I will press enter, you can identify I am getting hello world message. But here I think some confusion will come. Why? Just clearly observe. If I will get the list, please concentrate. If I will get the list, you can identify dot java file hai, bilkul sahi hai. Dot class file hai, bilkul sahi hai. लेकिन आउटपुट पाने के लिए टू गेट द आउटपुट वन फाइल वॉज रिक्वायर्ड, एक फाइल चाहिए था जो सी में क्रिएट हुआ था, सी प्लस प्लस में क्रिएट हुआ था, लेकिन जावा में क्रिएट नहीं हो रहा है. विच फाइल? यस यू आर राइट, मशीन कोड एक्सटेंशन. विच फाइल? डॉट आउट फाइल. बट यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई इन जावा वी आर गेटिंग द आउटपुट, बट इन जावा डॉट आउट फाइल इज नॉट लिस्टेड. जावा में आउटपुट तो मिल गया है लेकिन जावा में डॉट आउट फाइल लिस्टेड नहीं. तो इफ आई विल मेक द आर्किटेक्चर व्हाट वी डिड अप टू इट, अगर जो किए हैं उसके हिसाब से हम एक छोटा सा आर्किटेक्चर ड्रॉ कर लें तो बेहतर समझ में आएगा. सो व्हाट द आर्किटेक्चर विल लुक्स लाइक, जस्ट केयरफुली ऑब्जर्व हियर. सो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव ए फाइल हैविंग द नेम डॉट जावा, दैट्स आवर सोर्स कोड. इट्स गोइंग फॉर द फर्स्ट स्टेप. What is the first step? That's our compiler, Java C. From this compiler, which file was created? Yes, very good. Dot class file was created. This dot class file will move for the second step. What the second step? We know that's our Java, or we can tell that's our JVM. That's our interpreter. Finally, you know, user records output, and to get the output, what is required? Machine is required, right? Microprocessor is required. Microprocessor is required. For the microprocessor, one file was required, dot out file was required. But here, the question is what? Microprocessor is working with Java, that's why we are getting the output. बहुत सारे students समझते हैं कि जावा में मशीन काम नहीं कर रहा है, जावा में माइक्रो प्रोसेसर काम नहीं कर रहा है. दैट्स रॉन्ग. इन जावा ऑल्सो माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज वर्किंग. इफ माइक्रो प्रोसेसर इज वर्किंग, मशीन कोड वॉज रिक्वायर्ड, बट मशीन कोड इज नॉट जनरेटेड. मशीन कोड तो जनरेट नहीं हुआ है. इफ मशीन कोड इज नॉट जनरेटेड, विदाउट द मशीन कोड हाउ द मशीन इज वर्किंग एंड प्रोवाइडिंग द आउटपुट टू द यूजर, दिस इज द डाउट वी हैव. We will work on this doubt. I will clear this doubt on Python programming language. Not required to worry, but this is not the right time to clear that doubt. So, just keep this doubt with yourself. We will discuss on the doubt later. Clear? Okay. So, in Java, two steps are working. The first step is the compiler. Second step is the interpreter. The compiler name is Java. So, interpreter name is Java. We can tell JVM. Two files are there, dot java, dot class. Important thing, just carefully identify. Dot java, we know that's our which code, source code, like that. Dot class is not the intermediate code, that's not the object code, that's not the assembly code. Dot class is technically called, if you know Java, you can identify, that's called bytecode. Sometimes students are thinking this bytecode is the machine code. No, machine code means binary means bit code is the machine code. Bit and byte, not the same thing, different thing. 7-8 bit is one byte, right? So bytecode is not the machine code. Don't think that bytecode is the machine code here. So here two files are there, but one file was expected, that's not generated. Dot out file, machine code was expected, but that's not generated. Why that's not generated, we will discuss on that later on Python style. But in Java, two steps only: the first step compiler, second step interpreter. The compiler name is Java C, interpreter name is Java, technically called JVM, and two files, source code and bytecode. What are the bytecode extension in Java? Dot class. Just remember this architecture. And what are the doubts we have, we will discuss on that later. I think this Java architecture is clear for you. If any doubts, then you can say, I'm just going to my group chat. If no doubts, please confirm. If any doubts, also please confirm. Please, please, please confirm in group chat, all the students. Okay. Amitesh, I got your confirmations. Ananya, yes, okay. Very good. Very good, very good. Right. So, now finally, we got what's our requirement, right? Okay, thank you. I got your message. I'm just leaving this panel. Sanjay, I got your message. Okay, thank you. The final things, we have to study the Python architecture. जिस तरीके से C, C++ का आर्किटेक्चर सेम होते हैं लाइक दैट पाइथन एंड जावा आर्किटेक्चर, जावा एंड पाइथन आर्किटेक्चर इज एग्जैक्टली सेम, इज एग्जैक्टली सेम. सी में चार स्टेप, सी प्लस प्लस में चार स्टेप, लाइक दैट जावा में कितना स्टेप होते हैं, राइट, टू स्टेप्स, लाइक दैट in Python also two steps are there. So let's first I am making the architecture, after that I will go for the system. Thoda reverse kar lete hain. So later I am deleting all these Java discussion points. Yes, we know Python architecture will looks like Python architecture will be looks like Java architecture. Any message? Okay. So I'm going to my whiteboard. If I'll go for the Python architecture, in Python also internally two steps are working. The first step is the compiler, second step is the interpreter. Same steps. Compiler is the first step, second step is the interpreter. Java compiler name was Java C, but Python compiler name, I think some students are thinking, sir, in the previous class you told that in Python there is no any compilation steps, but now you are telling there is a compiler. We will discuss on that, not for too worry. In Python the compiler name, please remember, in Python the compiler name is CPython. C Python. Java में जो C होता है वो last में होता है, लेकिन Python में जो C है ये पहले. Java C, in Python C Python. In Java the interpreter name was Java. C सबसे Python का interpreter का नाम क्या बनना चाहिए? Yes, it's the Python. Java का जो interpreter था उसको हम technically बोलते थे JVM, like that. The Python interpreter, we can tell technically PVM stands for Python virtual. P stands for virtual. M stands for machine. P stands for Python virtual. Python virtual process. Right? So you can identify Python steps and Java steps are exactly the same. Only the names are different. In Python, two steps are working: compiler and interpreter. The compiler name is CPython, interpreter name is itself Python, technically called, that's the technical name, PVM. So you know PVM is not the command, which command is required to target the interpreter, the command is what? Python, right? If I will make the architecture, please concentrate. In Python, you know the source code extension is not .py. It will move inside the first step. The first step is our CPython compiler. From this CPython compiler, as a kind of case confirm, in Java what the file was created after the compilation?
Yes, yes, you are right. Dot class was created, but in Python, here dot class will be not created. Please concentrate here. Dot pyc will be created. Pyc stands for py stands for Python. C stands for compile. Python compile. We can. After the compilation, dot pyc file will be created. Pyc stands for Python compile file. This dot pyc file will move for the second step. What is the second step? That's our interpreter. What is the interpreter name? That's our PVM. PVM stands for Python. Python virtual machine. PVM stands for Python virtual machine. Okay. PVM. So second step is our PVM there. Let's take a look. Interpreter. After that, we know finally for every programming language, finally what is required? Output is it? Who provides the output to the user? Yes. Finally, microprocessor will provide the output to the user. Microprocessor will provide output to the user. Definitely, in Python also, microprocessor is working. And for the microprocessor, which file was required? Yes, for the microprocessor, Python code was required, or you can tell dot out file was required. Later, dot out file, how many of it was the virtual machine code previous microprocessor काम कर रहा था. Like that, Python may be microprocessor to काम कर रहा. Later, Python may be machine code generating. Just remember, like Java. Machine code was not created in Java, but still you are getting the output with the help of microprocessor. Like that, in Python, microprocessor is working with Python programming language to provide the output, but still machine code is not generated. This is the architecture of Python. So in Python, two steps are working. The first step is the compiler, second step is the interpreter. The compiler name is CPython, interpreter name is PVM, or you can tell Python. We know .py file is technically called which code? That's technically called source code. We know that one. Like that, .pyc file is technically called, yes, file. That's different. In Java, also bytecode was there. In Python, also bytecode is here. Difference is what? In Java, jo bytecode tha, उसका एक्सटेंशन डॉट क्लास था, लेकिन पाइथन में जो बाइटकोड है, पाइथन बाइटकोड एक्सटेंशन इज नॉट डॉट क्लास, पाइथन बाइटकोड एक्सटेंशन इज व्हाट? डॉट पीवाईसी. पीवाईसी स्टैंड्स फॉर पाइथन, सी फॉर कंपाइल्ड फाइल. दैट्स नॉट द सोर्स कोड, दैट्स नॉट द मशीन कोड, दैट्स स्विच कोड, दैट्स आवर बाइटकोड, राइट? आई थिंक दिस आर्किटेक्चर is clear for you. So later I am going to my system to prove this architecture is valid or not. So if I'll go for my Linux, later I am writing a Python program. You know how to implement a Python program. File ka name to kuch bhi ho sakta hai. Test ka naam ABC ho sakta hai. XYZ ho sakta hai. But what the extension is required? .py. And writing print hello. This message is given late this much. Yes, you can identify Python source code is created. In the previous class, what we did to execute the program, we are using this command python, then your file name. Agar file ka naam abc.py hota, to yahan pe python abc.py likha jata. If I'll press enter, I am getting hello world. Thoda dhyan se observe kijiye. If I will get the list now, you can identify from java dot class was created, but from dot py
dot pyc file is not created. Why dot pyc is not created? Because you not access the compiler. What is the compiler name in Python? Yes, you know, C Python. Important point now. Python does not allow, important, Python does not allow you to access C Python compiler. Python C Python को access करने का permission नहीं दिया है. If I will press enter, it's giving some message. Command not found. C Python compiler को आप directly access नहीं कर सकते हैं. Java C को हम directly access कर सकते हैं. लेकिन C Python को हम directly access नहीं कर सकते हैं. Then Python given another solution. Python बोलता है अगर आप C Python को access करना चाहते हैं तो command थोड़ा change कर लीजिए. Command क्या change करना होगा? Please write with me. Python space hyphen C. This stands for C Python. Just think that this stands for C Python. Inside single quotation. Yes, this is my single quotation. Just write this point. Inside single quotation, we have to write import. Then we have to provide file name. जो फाइल के अंदर आप प्रोग्राम लिखे हैं तो हम कौन सा फाइल के अंदर प्रोग्राम लिखे हैं? टेस्ट डॉट पी वाई. थोड़ा ध्यान से, तो फाइल नेम की जगह क्या रिप्लेस करना होगा? टेस्ट डॉट पी वाई. लेकिन थोड़ा चेंज करना होगा. चेंज क्या करना है? यहां पे डॉट पी वाई मेंशन नहीं करना है. थोड़ा ध्यान से, सी पाइथन को एक्सेस करने के लिए ये सिंटैक्स होता है, पाइथन then space, then hyphen c, then space, then in single quotation, single quote के अंदर, single quote, import, this is fix, python is fix, hyphen c is fix, import is fix, but this test is a variable. अगर फाइल का नाम abc है, abc.py है, तो आपको abc लिखना होगा. अगर xyz.py है, तो आपको xyz लिखना होगा, लेकिन extension नहीं डालना है. डॉट पी वाई नहीं डाल. सो नाउ इफ आई विल गेट द लिस्ट, थोड़ा ध्यान से ऑब्जर्व कीजिए. जिस तरीके से डॉट जावा से डॉट क्लास फाइल क्रिएट हुआ था, उसी हिसाब से डॉट पी वाई से विच फाइल इज क्रिएटेड? यस, डॉट पी वाई सी इज क्रिएटेड. यू नो पी वाई सी स्टैंड्स फॉर पाइथन कंपाइल्ड फाइल. डॉट पी वाई इज आवर सोर्स कोड. डॉट पी वाई सी इज आवर बाइट कोड. बाइट कोड क्रिएट होने के बाद अगर ये बाइट कोड को, ये डॉट पी वाई से बाइट कोड है, अगर आप ये बाइट कोड को सेकंड स्टेप में सेंड कर लेंगे, यू नो सेकंड स्टेप इज द इंटरप्रेटर, इंटरप्रेटर इज पीवीएम. लेकिन पीवीएम के नाम से कोई कमांड नहीं होता है, कमांड तो पाइथन वाला ही चलता है. लेकिन अगर आप देखेंगे तो पाइथन में अभी डॉट पी वाई प्रोवाइड नहीं किए हैं, बाइट कोड को प्रोवाइड किए हैं. नाउ इफ आई विल प्रेस एंटर, यस you can identify I am getting also my output. I am getting what? Hello. So in this way, this is proved in Python one step is not working. In Python how many steps are working there? Two steps are working. The first step is the compiler. Compiler is responsible to convert the source code to bytecode. Second step is the interpreter. Interpreter is not generating the machine code, but machine is working with Java, also with Python, and providing the output. So this is the doubts we have, how machine is working with Java and Python without machine code. What are the doubts? Again, I am repeating, how machine is working with Java and Python. Forget about Java, that's not our topic. How machine is working with Python without machine code. Machine Python के साथ किस तरीके से काम कर रहा है machine code के बिना, we will discuss on that. But before that, first I think this Python architecture is clear or not, please confirm. I am just going to my group chat panel, please confirm this. If any doubts, you can share with me. Very good, Asutosh. I got your message. Susri, right? I got your message. All students, please confirm. Yes, Chakraborty. Translista, right? Ananya, Sanjay, very good. Any doubts? Any doubts you can ask. So, if I will recall the story, if I will recall the story here, yes, Apurva, I got your message. Okay, fine. If I will recall the story of what we studied today, I am writing all the things for you. I think introduction chapter is going on. First, we studied some basic Linux commands. Next, we implemented Hello World program, Hello World program in C, C++, Java, and in Python. Next, we know how to compile the program and how to run in C, C++, Java, and in Python. Today, we studied internals of C, C internally. किस तरीके से काम कर रहा है, क्योंकि हम पाइथन पढ़ने जा रहे हैं तो बेसिक आइडिया जो सी में है वो तो चाहिए, और आज हम जो सीखे हैं वो थोड़ा डेप्थ नॉलेज हो गया है. सो नाउ वी कैन से सर वी नो पाइथन बिकॉज वी हैव सम डेप्थ नॉलेज ऑन सी, हाउ दीज थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग इंटरनली. इंटरनल्स ऑफ सी, लाइक दैट वी स्टडीड इंटरनल्स ऑफ सी प्लस प्लस. नेक्स्ट वी स्टडीड इंटरनल्स ऑफ जावा. Next, we studied internals of Python. So, let I am repeating all the things shortly. In C, four steps are working. First step, second step, third step, and fourth step. Four steps are working. The first step is the preprocessor. Second step is the compiler. Third step is the assembler. Fourth step is the linker. And load. In C++ also four steps are working there. I am not writing the steps name, I am just writing the technical name. Preprocessor name is CPP, compiler name is G++, assembler name is AS, linker loader, you know, that's our LD. Like that, in Java, not four steps are there. In Java, we know already. In Java, two steps are working. The first step is the compiler. Second step is the interpreter. The compiler name in Java is Java C. Interpreter name in Java is technically called Java. No, Java and technically called JVM. In Python, two steps are working. The first step is the compiler. You know, second step is the interpreter. Compiler name in Python, as you know, that's our C Python. Interpreter name, that's our Python. Or we can tell PVM. PVM stands for Python Virtual Machines. We know PVM stands for, I'm just writing. PVM stands for Python Virtual Machine. So .py file we have, it will move inside C Python, and from this one .py C will be created. It will move inside the PVM. .out file will be not created, but you will get the out. So .py is nothing but that's our source code. And .pyc, that's our, it stands for, it's our bytecode, but pyc stands for python compiled file, or you can tell that's our bytecode. Another thing to remember, C Python no command available. Yahan pe C Python ke naam se koi command nahi hota hai. तो अगर आपको C Python को एक्सेस करना है, .pyc फाइल को क्रिएट करना है, तो तो आपको कमांड देना होता है पाइथन हाइफेन सी इन सिंगल कोटेशन यू हैव टू राइट इंपोर्ट देन इन एंगुलर ब्रैकेट आई एम राइटिंग बिकॉज दैट्स ए वेरिएबल दैट्स द वे टू रिप्रेजेंट जो चीज एंगुलर ब्रैकेट के अंदर होते हैं उसके जगह आप वैल्यू रिप्लेस कर सकते हैं सो यू हैव टू प्रोवाइड फाइल नेम लेकिन डॉट पी वाई एक्सटेंशन नहीं डालना है थोड़ा याद रखिएगा ओनली द फाइल नेम जो फाइल आप क्रिएट किया है उसी फाइल का नाम आप डाल दीजिए सो आफ्टर दैट यू कैन एंजॉय योर डॉट पी वाई सी फाइल दैट्स नॉट मशीन कोड दैट्स आवर बाइट द बाइट कोड एक्सटेंशन इन जावा इज डॉट क्लास एंड द बाइट कोड एक्सटेंशन इन पाइथन इज डॉट पी वाई सी राइट